I'm playing with Teddy Williams, who is a fierce competitor. He's one of the top local players and has been for a long time. Also, I'm playing with Oliver Taylor, who has won several of these open tournaments in the past, and he too always provides good play. And Jack Cape, who is another sort of local celebrity, famous British celebrity as well. I think the three of them hopefully will do all the work and I can get in. He plays each other in the round robin stage. And for the final day, the first place team based on points, and there's an order of merit system to determine the first, second, third, fourth, fifth in the league. First and second play each other in finals, and third and fourth play each other in subsidiary finals. The fifth team would not play on the final day. So it's quite an intense tournament with a match scheduled almost every other day. With five teams in one league, they all play each other. A win here, and there are 2 points awarded for a win, and of course 0 points awarded for a loss. And so the first consideration for the order of merit is points. So if one team were to win all four of their preliminary matches and have 8 points, they would let you first. Often teams are tied in points, and in this particular instance, the teams that are looked at to determine who won matches against each other first as the second consideration, and then thirdly looked at in terms of goal difference. So basically goals scored for and against are in the third level of determination to be able to rank the teams from first to fifth.
One of the things I would say with Polo is that, unlike some of these sports, is that a lot of players are accessible. You know, you can actually meet the player after the match, and you can have a drink, and as you said, socialize and interact with your favorite players and so on and so forth. And you know, there are quite a number of sports that are as accessible to your players and competitors as to followers. So, in some ways, yes, you're right, but in others, I think the Polo has a very sociable atmosphere, and it's good.
And very family friendly.
Nordicy is going to have the opportunity to showcase a new product in collaboration, hopefully, with First Citizens. We can do some more business. But we are actually going to be promoting our Hyundai line. We're launching our cars in the next month. And we're actually going through some major renovations and so with our dealership. So this is an opportunity for us to showcase our product. Echoing Sharon's sentiments, we believe that Polo is making a significant contribution by adding value to the tourism product here in Barbados. We are also involved in the tourism industry through our rental car business, and it's going to make an overall contribution to the economy. So we really like supporting this sport. There are many facets of this sport that people don't see besides just being fun and entertaining. And people want to come here, and they also want to invest here as a result of this sport.
I'm playing with young Maxie here, who's the fellow professional in the team, who's the up and coming English star. We just played together last week in the Arena Gold Cup in England, and we managed to win that together. We've played together a lot in England before, so hopefully that will help us. As Maxie has been coming up with handicaps in a sort of meteoric rise. And then with us we have Gary Shepherd, who is the first group man. He is his team, shared with Stephen Williams, Sir Charles's son, who has a huge amount of experience. Gary's improving all the time. Polly's here coaching him and managing the team, always helping him with his polo and his horses. So we're very lucky to have Ollie on board as his manager coach. And Stephen has a huge amount of experience, been playing for a long, long time all around the world, and he can pull out his A game at any moment. Takes Hill are helping Max and I with horses, and Stephen, so Steve, three of us on the team are managed by Sir Charles Hill, so we have some really nice things. So lucky enough to win this cup with Stewart and Nissan 2 years ago, courtesy car, courtesy Miss Mancosa 2 years ago, so I'm confident that we should be competitive. You always need luck in sport. You need lucky umpire decisions, and you need luck on the day to put the ball beside the goal, the goalpost that means whether you win or you lose. So fingers crossed, we should be